How they crack the lottery for millions. Win the lottery and do whatever you want. That's the dream for almost anyone that plays the lottery. And for the vast majority of lottery winners that win millions, they relied on the chance to get their wins. But for one small town Michigan couple, it was different. They used math to win a total of $26 million from playing the lottery. Jerry and Marge Selbee figured out a loophole in the Michigan state lotteries. According to Jerry, it only took, quote, good old basic arithmetic to crack the code on certain lottery games. And they used it to their advantage to win the lottery thousands of times for 9 years. So, what exactly was this basic arithmetic? Let's find out. Long before Jerry Selbee was cracking the code on winning the lottery, he first broke the code of the breakfast industry in 1966. Jerry started work for Kellogg's in Michigan as a materials analyst. Jerry was always into science and math. So, what does his job have to do with the lottery? According to HuffPost, Jerry noticed a string of letters and numbers stamped on a General Mills cereal box, which was one of the products on Kellogg's main competitor. He basically figured out how to trace any General Mills box of cereal back to its exact plant, shift, date, and time of its creation. If it were a different industry other than the cereal business, cracking a competitor's trade secrets might have generated Jerry millions of dollars in profit. He wasn't all about the money, though. Jerry just really enjoyed puzzles ever since he was a child. While Jerry grew up dyslexic and struggled through his reading assignments, he actually possessed another academic gift. That gift was in math. In fact, he took a standardized test in 8th grade that showed he could solve math problems at the level of a college junior. But let's quickly fast forward a few years. Jerry married his high school sweetheart, Marge, and had 6 kids with her. Jerry went and got an associate's degree from Kellogg Community College, a bachelor's in mathematics, and business from Western Michigan University, and he even got an MBA. He and Marge lived a quiet life in Michigan. However, his brain would not quit working. He had actually mastered in math, but he wasn't able to finish it because of starting a family. Jerry just couldn't stop learning and thinking about numbers. He worked a series of factory and corporate jobs. He held positions such as a chemist at a sewage treatment plant and a salesman at a pharmaceutical company. But in 1984, he decided to stop working for big corporate. So he and Marge decided to run a convenience store. It was during this time that Jerry's puzzle solving really took off. He enjoyed solving any sort of financial puzzles that involved their store. And one of those puzzles involved the lottery machine they installed. Jerry became extremely familiar with all the odds for any games that the lottery came out with over the years. The lottery profits over the years helped to pay for the education of their 6 kids. Jerry and Marge retired in 2000, and Jerry's morning routine still included visiting the store and its new owners. It was then in 2003 that he saw the brochure for the new lottery game, Windfall. One windfall ticket cost $1. Players pick 6 numbers from 1 through 49. A player would win the jackpot if they got all 6 of the numbers correct, and the jackpot was guaranteed to be at the very least $2 million. If no one won the jackpot, it would grow in size. And there was a big catch that completely made Windfall the lottery to play. If no one won the jackpot when it reached $5 million, the jackpot's roll down would be triggered. This meant that if any players had tickets that had anywhere from 2 to 5 numbers, they won some cash. And it was this exact roll down in cash prizes that intrigued Jerry. Because when the jackpot reached $5 million and triggered a roll down, it could be timed. The roll down would happen roughly every 6 weeks. While the state lotteries had roll downs, Windfalls was structured differently. According to Jerry, it only took him 3 minutes to figure out the game's big potential. He figured out that for a regular week without a roll down, players had a 1 in 54 chance to pick 3 out of 6 numbers to win $5. It was a 1 in 1500 chance to pick 4 numbers correctly, which would win $100. When the jackpot roll down was triggered, the prizes were different. Each winning 3 number combination would win $50 instead of $5. For tickets with winning 4 number combinations, the payout would be $1,000 instead of the usual $100. Jerry quickly realized that the game had a positive EV. This meant that for every dollar he played, he would make more than a dollar. The worst thing that could happen was if someone won the jackpot. That meant no one else would win anything. But this still didn't make the game a losing proposition. Jerry couldn't believe that the hundreds of employees at the state lottery had overlooked a math loophole that was so obvious to him. He decided to test his theory. The first time he played, he spent $2,200. He got back $2,150. He lost $50, but Jerry knew he just had slightly bad luck. He knew his math was right and he didn't give up. Jerry realized that he needed to keep playing on a bigger scale, and that meant more tickets, and more tickets meant more money. So when the next roll down was announced, Jerry bought $3,400 worth of windfall tickets. Marge didn't like risk. She was the pragmatic one in their relationship and she disliked the uncertainty. And Jerry didn't exactly explain his calculations to her. Fortunately for Jerry, his math indeed was correct. The second time he played, he won $6,300 for a return of 46%. The third time he played, he put $8,000 on the line. This time his prize money was up to $15,700, which was a 49% return on his money. By this time, Jerry was absolutely certain he had cracked the Michigan State Lottery. So he decided to let Marge in on his big plan. He wanted to play for as much money as possible. He knew that he found his money-making machine. All he needed was to crank as much money into it as he could. Jerry and Marge soon started playing for hundreds of thousands of dollars. But with the sheer amount of money and legwork needed, they started recruiting other people. They decided to start a betting group. The Michigan Lottery allowed large betting groups, so it wasn't anything illegal. Jerry and Marge decided to get their kids in on the secret. They created a corporation called GS Investment Strategies LLC in order to legitimize all their winnings and losses and to properly account for taxes. Jerry and Marge started selling shares at $500 a piece to friends and family. GS Investment eventually expanded to 25 members. His members included a state trooper, a parole officer, a bank vice president, three lawyers, and his personal accountant, Steve Wood. By 2005, GS Investment Strategies LLC had played windfall on 12 different roll-down weeks. Their bets increased anytime they had more access to capital. With more tickets bought, this meant more winnings. The profits just kept rolling in. But the money-making machine in Michigan couldn't last forever. In May 2005, the Michigan Lottery shut down windfall. They claimed that the sales of windfall tickets had been decreasing, something that factored into their decision. Luckily for Jerry and Marge, the very next month, one of their members saw that Massachusetts was promoting a brand new lottery game. The game was named something slightly different. It was called Cash Windfall. There were a few other differences, but the basics were still the same. For example, one difference was how much cash windfall tickets cost. It was $2 instead of just $1. Players also had to pick numbers from 1 to 46 instead of 1 to 49, and the jackpot rolled down when it got up to $2 million, not $5 million. Jerry quickly made the calculations, and he came to the conclusion that this game wasn't any different than Windfall. It was another profitable lottery game that made sense to play. Jerry and Marge drove over to Massachusetts during August of 2005. They spent $120,000 on 60,000 cash Windfall tickets the first time they played. They stayed at the Red Roof Inn and basically had tickets all over their room. They were so busy counting tickets that they never left their room except just to get food. And once they claimed their winning tickets, they would drive back to Michigan with the thousands of losing tickets. They would store them in plastic tubs in their barn in case any IRS auditors wanted to see the paper trail when they claimed losing tickets against their winning tickets. For over 5 years, Jerry and Marge would drive to Massachusetts anywhere from 6 to 9 times a year to repeat the process. They would go, buy, and print the tickets, count them at the Red Roof Inn, redeem the winners for a giant check, and then drive back to Michigan with the losing tickets in their trunk. What Jerry and Marge didn't know was that they weren't the only betting groups. One student at the Massachusetts Institute of Technology named James Harvey had also cracked the code to the lottery. He had analyzed all the different state games in Massachusetts as part of his research to graduate. Just like Jerry, he figured out that playing cash windfall was like printing money, and he formed his own betting company. Find out more in this video here. As the game went on, the MIT students played with more aggression by making an insanely large bet. In 2010, they bought 700,000 lottery tickets, which cost about $1.4 million. Apparently, it was more than enough to take the jackpot over $2 million before the lottery officials knew what was happening. The MIT students won up to 700,000 $100,000 in cash profit. Another player who had discovered the secret was a biomedical researcher at Boston University named Ying Zhang. Zhang formed his own club called the Dr. Zhang Lottery Club Limited Partnership, and he got his friends to play. They played anywhere between $300,000 and $500,000 during roll-down weeks. The game was so profitable for Zhang, he even quit his job as a biomedical researcher to focus on playing the lottery full-time. But with all the betting groups going on, the Massachusetts State Lottery became aware of several irregularities in cash windfall. The unusual patterns they noticed indicated that something was up. By 2011, the Boston Globe received a tip and found that in certain Massachusetts locations, cash windfall tickets were being sold in huge volumes. The Boston Globe's investigative reporters revealed that the Selbys and the MIT betting group were dominating cash windfall. And that was the beginning of the end. The Boston Globe articles raised suspicions that the game was rigged. The Massachusetts state treasurer eventually shut down cash windfall and started an official investigation. There was also news that made it look like Jerry was a cheater, but the investigation revealed that the two groups were actually winning completely legally, and the state had made a lot of money because of them playing. Jerry and Marge played cash windfall for the last time back in January 2012. From their 9 years of playing the lottery, they earned a total of $26 million and made about $8 million in profit before taxes. According to the HuffPost, Jerry still plays the lottery sometimes. He plays the multi-state Powerball jackpot. Other times, he would also go to a casino and play poker, just like any smart, calculated gambler. Jerry used the money to buy coins from the U.S. Mint as a hedge against inflation to protect his family from future catastrophes. He was also able to fill 5 different safe deposit boxes with gold and silver coins. The Selbys also used their winnings to renovate their house and help pay for their grandchildren and great-grandchildren's education. They also developed a new business venture in construction financing. Jerry now lends money to home builders in his local area who provide housing for military veterans. Who knows? Maybe a movie is in the future, as they also gave the option for their life story to be turned into a movie. Here's what's next.